Welcome everyone. My name is Anja Adamov and I'm a doctoral researcher at ETH Zurich. Today I'm happy to present our open source software Q2 Fondue that allows you to conduct a fair meta-analysis of nucleotide sequence data. Over the past two decades, there has been a steep increase of freely available nucleotide sequence data. More and more studies started uploading their sequence data and making it findable on databases such as NCBI's Sequence Read Archive. The synthesis of these datasets promises to yield novel discoveries and to improve our understanding of certain biological questions. To avoid manual retrieval steps, tools started emerging that allow the user to programmatically access these datasets. Since these tools were developed independently, they don't necessarily allow for an interoperable and reusable workflow. Also, for users with limited programming skills, the setup requirements of these existing tools might be a bit too complex to get started. To overcome these bottlenecks, we developed Q2 Fondue, an open source Python package that allows the conduct of a meta-analysis in a full, fair fashion. The main functionality of Q2 Fondue is that it allows you to fetch sequence data and associated metadata from NCBI's Sequence Read Archive. It performs this fetch in a fully reproducible manner, and we also made sure to optimize the download. For one, during the download, we use all available computational cores to parallelize the fetch process, and we also prevent data loss from happening. In addition, we validate and standardize the output formats. Once that data download is finished, the user can choose to further analyze the datasets in any programming language of their choice or in a bioinformatics platform. The outputs are interoperable with the widely used and open source bioinformatics platform called Chime2. If a user wanted to start the meta-analysis from a publication library, we added functionality that allows you to scrape through the publications in a Zotero library to identify the IDs of the datasets to be fetched. As you can see, this whole process allows for a fully reproducible and optimized meta-analysis. To showcase this, let's have a look at an example use case of an amplicon sequence analysis of an infant's gut microbiome. If we were to conduct a meta-analysis, we would first need to choose the studies to include in the meta-analysis. And then we'd upload their publications into a Zotero web library. Then we could use the scrape functionality of Fondue to identify the accession IDs of the datasets of these studies. With these accession IDs, we could then fetch the sequence data of these studies and further analyze it, for example, in Chime2. This analysis might yield a final result like this, where we'd see the differences in the diversity metrics of the two studies. The main characteristic of using Q2 Fondue for this analysis is that it captures each download and analysis step in provenance. So each step is saved together with the output in the output file. If you want to learn more about Q2 Fondue or see more use cases, such as a whole genome analysis, have a look at our peer-reviewed publication in bioinformatics. I hope with this I managed to convince you that using Q2 Fondue makes sense for your next meta-analysis because each step from data download to final visualization is provenance tracked. Additionally, through the integration of Q2 Fondue with Chime2, a wide range of plugins is available for further analysis. Q2 Fondue is fully open source, so feel free to contribute if you would like to see new functionality or create a feature request. We also make sure to continuously maintain the software such that it remains functionable in the future. So using Q2 Fondue, you can conduct your meta-analysis in a fully fair fashion. And with this, I'd like to thank you for your attention. and I hope to see you at our poster booth at this conference, or otherwise feel free to reach out via any of these channels. Thank you very much.